Hi everyone, in this video I want to discuss what is known as the unseen species problem. So this is an estimation problem that has been solved by statisticians in the past a couple of different ways, and I want to just talk about the common way of estimating this problem, or a common estimator for this problem, and some history on it. So the first person to discuss this question was Ronald A. Fisher. He was presented data by a naturalist named Corbett. Corbett had collected data on Lepidoptera, which is an order of insects that are commonly known as butterflies and moths. So many different moths and butterflies are Lepidoptera, including the monarch butterfly, and Google Images said that these are some other examples of butterflies as well. So this is known as Corbett's butterfly problem, although moths are included in the order as well. And this was the data that was presented to Ronald A. Fisher that is commonly used as an example for the unseen species problem. Corbett had collected a total number of samples of 2,029 different Lepidoptera, moths and butterflies. And from his entire sample, he was able to identify different species of butterflies. So sometimes you could get two samples and the samples would be the same species of butterfly, or sometimes they would be different. And the way this data is grouped in this table, there were 118 species of butterfly that were only sampled one time. Similarly, there were 75 species of butterflies that were sampled two times. And at the end, there were six species of butterflies that were sampled 15 times. So if you do 118 times 1 plus 74 times 2, etc., this would give you a total sample of 2,029. Then, for the total number of species that were found, if you sum this row, the total number of species found was 435. So we have 2,029 as our sample, which discovered 435 species of butterflies and moths. So the question that Corbett posed to Ronald A. Fisher was, if I keep sampling and increasing my sample size, how many new species will I discover? So I haven't discovered these unseen species, but I want an estimator or an estimate of how many new species I will find. I will put the Ronald A. Fisher paper in the description box below. So he was the first person to come up with a solution for this problem. And his solution is a logarithmic series. So his solution works, but you have to find the constant. And the constant will change depending on what you are applying the problem to. So there are one set of constants for the butterfly problem. If you use this unseen species problem to other applications, each application, kind of like each domain or sample that you're talking about, will have its own set of constants. But he showed in the paper different applications for this type of estimate on different data and with different constants. So his method does work, and it was the first one to address this problem at all. Later on, several statisticians have their own equations and have built on this work of the unseen species problem. And this unseen species problem has multiple applications. I think one famous application of this is, for example, people wanted to know how many words does Shakespeare know? And so they calculated every word in every piece of literature that Shakespeare has ever published. Then they counted the number of unique words and their frequencies, and then they estimated how many words did he know, but maybe he never used. So you can do that using this unseen species problem solution, the estimator from this problem. So this has various applications across a lot of different fields. It's usually associated with ecology because of this Ronald A. Fisher initial butterfly example. So to solve this problem, I'm not going to use Fisher's equations. I'm going to use a later equation, which is still used, although people have also expanded on this and updated this because it comes from the 1950s. But a very famous estimator is called the Good Toulmin estimator for this unseen species problem. And so using this data set, I'm going to go over how you would estimate the number of new unseen species you would identify given a sample size of new future samples. So pulling the Good Toulmin estimator equation just from Wikipedia, and also pulling this table from Wikipedia, the estimator is defined as follows. The number of unseen species U is defined as, or equal to, the sum of negative t to I plus 1 times phi I for I equal to 1 to infinity. So it's an infinite sum, and In this case, t is equal to m divided by n. M is going to be the number of future samples you want. So how much more are you going to keep sampling? Whereas n is equal to the number of past samples. In our case, we have 2029 samples already. And phi is equal to the number of species observed I times. So this table already gives you the values for phi I. As we have already said, you observe 118 species of butterflies one time, you observe 74 species twice, etc. Even though this estimate is very old, it still holds up pretty well, and it's actually pretty easy to plug in as well. So statisticians have found that the Good Toulmin estimator still works pretty well when t is less than or equal to 1. So basically, you want the future number of samples to be less than or equal to the number of past samples. For cases where you want to sample even more than the data that you have, the sample size that you have, there are other estimators that people have come up with. But I'm going to use this one. One thing that's nice about the Good Toulmin estimator is that it's very easy to actually plug in all the values that you have and solve for the equation once you have all the unknowns. So let's go ahead and, using this data as an example, let's calculate the number of unseen species, and let's assume that the future number of samples is going to be equal to the past number of samples, so that our t will equal 1. So this will mean that we're just going to plug in negative 1 into the equation here, and that means that we're going to have 2029 new samples of butterflies. So our estimator u for the number of unseen species is going to be equal to the sum of I from 1 to infinity of negative 1 to the I plus 1 times phi sub I. Using our data table that we have, that's going to be equal to, for I is equal to 1, we're going to have negative 1 to the 1 plus 1, which is 2, times phi. So we observe 118 species one time. So phi is going to be 118 plus, now we're going to go to I equal to 2. So when I is equal to 2, we're going to have negative 1 to the third times 74. As you can see, this is going to be basically a sum where you have negative 1 squared will give you 1, and then the second sum is negative. So it's going to be 118 minus 74 plus minus plus minus. So this is just going to go back and forth. So in other words, we can write u is equal to 118 minus 74 plus 44 minus 24 plus 29 and so on. So I'm just going to go ahead and write out the equation that way. Okay, so I have all the values written out. So this is basically just summing up the number of species that were given in the data table and then oscillating back and forth plus, minus, plus, minus. When we do this entire sum, our number of unseen species that we would expect to collect, if we collected 2029 more samples, would be 75 new species. And so this is the value that Ronald A. Fisher gave to Corbett in his paper. So for the sake of the video, I don't really have anything else to add, and I will pretty much wrap up here, but I do think that this is an interesting problem. As I'm making the video, I'm wondering if anyone has ever actually tested this, so I wonder if anyone has ever gotten a certain number of samples and then tried to get more samples to actually test if this is an accurate estimator. But anyway, I'm going to end the video here, and thank you guys for watching.